So coming up in a few, we're going to be joined by Bob Chapman, who is a wonderful guest to have in today's economic turmoil, because there are so many questions that are running through people's heads that I'm hoping we can have Bob on. He's new to our show. He's not new to GCN. He's not new to radio. He's not new to television. He's been around for a while, but he's new to our show, so I'm hoping that he can help us bring some insight and information to our listeners. Before the break, I was talking about another host on a completely different network who has a little bit of a southern drawl, talks about getting out of debt and making over your money. Here's the bottom line. I love what he does. I mentioned him in the book. Matter of fact, I even named a chapter after him in the book, talking about how we need to get out of debt. What he does is needed. I'm not trying to rip on Dave Ramsey, and that's what I'm talking about. I'm not trying to rip on him. I think, you know, what he does is great. It's awesome. But what it points out is a larger problem, that victory is now nothing. Nothing. Victory is now nothing. The point, the biggest part of celebration is when people call in and say, yes, we're back to broke. And Andy Albright, who was our guest yesterday, he talked about the same thing. It was his first goal, his first step to get back to broke. Luckily, both Dave and Andy did something above and beyond getting back to broke, and that's what we need to talk about more often. That needs to be the push of the show. Both of them started businesses and became very wealthy men. And what alarms me in the conversations that we hear in this whole society where now victory is getting back to broke, we tell people, oh, go out and get, you know, another job, make your wife go get another job. Between the two of you, both of you should be working a full-time job and a part-time job. Eat beans and rice. Sacrifice. Save that money. So then when you're 70 years old, you can be financially secure and be on your way to wealth. I'm sorry. I object to that. Not the getting out of debt part, but the way you're going about doing it. If you're going to wait until you're 60 years old, 70 years old, to get out of debt or to sacrifice until then, something's wrong. Why is the new standard of excellence sacrificing until you're old and getting out of broke? Why isn't the new standard of excellence getting wealthy while you're young? Why isn't the message, hey, when you're 35 years old, you should only be working 20 hours a week. You should be spending the rest of the time with your wife and children. Why isn't the message, no, don't get four jobs between the two of you. Get less jobs between the two of you. Because more important than paying off the debt is maintaining your love life, your relationship with your children, your sanity. I don't want you to have any debt. Zero. I want you to have zero debt. But more important than having zero debt is having a good relationship with your husband or your wife or, you know. Because the debt doesn't last forever. But your love life should. You know, it's funny. It kind of takes me back to when teachers were telling me, you know, go to school, go to college, get good grades, get a good job. And they were telling over 100 people the same course of action. This is the way to happiness. Go to school, go to college, get good grades, get a good job. And it hit me then. You know, I don't know, maybe because I didn't participate I didn't participate actively in the school system. Maybe it just hit me as common sense. Wait a second. How can you tell a few hundred students that this is the course of action for happiness for all of us? We all have different dreams, different aspirations, different talents and abilities, but yet this formula is supposed to be what works for us? Are you nuts? What happened to love? What happened to passion? What happened to living an adventure? What happened to the question, what do you want to be when you grow up? Now we sacrifice that for an aptitude test, and the aptitude test tells us what we have to be when we grow up. If you want the life you want, this is how you go about doing it. You decide what life is. What is the life you want? And I want you to make that be anything you want. Don't take this as I'm making you want a Learjet or something. If you want to have a 5 acre or 500 acre spread in the middle of the woods and have your own, you know, little compound or something, go for it. I want you to do it. Please. But then go after that. Do whatever you have to do to make that happen. Design what you do for a living in a way that it fulfills your goal in life, not the other way around. Don't make your life fit your income. Make your income fit your life. And if you don't know how to do that, obviously I'm going to say pick up my book, but pick up any book that talks about this subject because it's too important. Are you going to die with the wish I coulda, woulda, shouldas? Well, I listen to the sound experts. I have my 401k. Let me tell you something about your 401k. Inflation cuts in half the value of money every 10 years. So let's say you had we're just going to use simple math. Let's say you had $100 today and you held on to it for 10 years. It's then worth 50. You hold on to it for another 10, it's now worth 25. So 20 years into this, your $100 is worth $25. That's why you can't get rich slowly. It has never happened. It can never happen, and nobody has gotten wealthy that way. Don't tell me, I listened to my investment broker, and he told me about the rule of 72. Yeah, I know about the rule of 72, too, but be quiet about it. Did he tell you about the rule of 1913? Did he tell you about the rule of 10% inflation? Inflation's not 3%. We have a soundbite of Ron Paul. I wish I had it up, but I don't. We have a soundbite of Ron Paul who is confronting Bernanke, and he's telling him also, you know what? We found that inflation is 9%+ a year. That means your income gets cut in half. Unless you get a 10% raise this year, you went backwards. Backwards. For goodness sakes, the price of food went up 35%. The price of wheat has more than doubled. So just to keep up with food prices, you need a 35% raise at work this year. And if you didn't get it, why are you still there? Before we get to Bob Chapman, I want to talk about hope. He's going to give us the lowdown dirty on the bad news that we're seeing. Then we have decisions to make as a people. I said it before, maybe it's a common theme. Are we going to decide to live in captivity in the zoo, or are we going to risk it and live for freedom? Life doesn't have to be this way. And I know this is a broad statement, but I'm talking to the 98% of you. Matter of fact, it's more than that, because only 1% of the people in this country are financially free. I'm talking to the 99% of you out there. Life doesn't have to be that way. Stop putting up the false front. Everybody knows you're not doing well. Stop pretending. Don't go into debt to make it look like you're doing well. Don't play the keeping up with the Joneses, because newsflash, the Joneses died in the 50s. Now who are you keeping up with? So get back to a place where you have hope. And how do we do that? The first thing you do is you sit down with yourself if you're single, your spouse if you're not, and you say, honey, or self, what do I want life to be? Just turn off the news for 72 hours. I don't care if the sky is falling. Turn it off for 72 hours. Sit down with a piece of blank paper and say, okay, what do I want my life to be? I only have X amount of years. What's it going to be? And decide, what are you going to have faith in? We talked about that yesterday. Even if you're an atheist, you have faith that there's nothing. That's still faith. So don't squibble and wander around about it. Make a decision. What do you believe in? What's important to you? Where do you want your life to go? And then create a vertical alignment that allows you to propel yourself in that manner. Because hope is not lost as long as we have breath. When we come back, we're going to be joined by Bob Chapman. We're going to get the lowdown dirty on the dirty. and see what we can do about it. You're listening to The Josh Tolley Show on the GCN Radio Network.